Hi guys, Aaron's Automotive here, and today I'm going to be doing a tool review. Okay, that's handier than I thought. This 233 piece Mastercraft mechanic tool set. I picked this thing up at Canadian Tire. It cost me $80 on sale. The off-sale price, was about $190 to $200 range. So, figured I'd snag this up. It never hurts to have a portable toolkit, and I figured this would be something that would come in handy, keep in the back seat of the vehicle, or in the trunk, break down on the side of the road, whatever. At least you have some sort of tool to do some work with. So, I guess we'll open it up and get to it. Take my knife here and cut the tape that holds the tab closed. Try not to damage the box. I like to keep my boxes for any tool I get just kind of in nice shape in case, you know, I ever need to return for warranty reasons or whatnot. This is the toolkit. Nice heavy. Looks like it's made out of blown molded plastic. It's got a couple of locks on the top here. Some nice durable heavy duty locks. And then looks like it's just got a couple of cheap plastic locks just on the side of it. Four locks. I'm pretty sure the first use in the cold. And these will break off. But these blue locks, you know, they look very, very sturdy, very securely made. Spin this around for you. You can see. So they do look like they're very securely made. Pop those off. There we go. And then. That was loose in there. This pops off. And looks like I have some Torx Allen or Torx wrenches that were set loose too. Along with a half inch. Other than that, everything looks like it's in there secure. So I'll put this down and we will get a closer look at the toolkit. Alright, so with the toolkit on the ground, take a look at it. We'll start up at the top here. Looks like we've got about five wrenches varying between 3/8 sockets, deep wells. Looks like they vary from 14 up to 19 millimeter. And then it goes straight from a 19 to 21. On this side we've got 9/16, 5/8, 11/16, and 3/4. Along with, that is a focus. Spark plug socket. And it is 3/8 spark plug socket. And then a 13/16 spark plug socket. In the bottom row, these again look like 3/8 sockets, shallow. They vary from 14
15, 16. They go up to 19. And then we have 9/16, 5/8, 11/16, 3/4, 13/16, and our 7/8. Over here, we have what looks to be our Torx reverse head or reverse Torx bolts. Instead of using a Torx socket, like this, looks like we use one of these. That's not bad. They go from E8, E10, E11, 12, E14, E16, E18, and E20. So kind of a variance of some sockets there. For adapters, we have, looks like a 3/8 drive to a 1/4 inch adapter. And then looks like we have a 1/2 inch drive to a 3/8 drive adapter. We also have, looks to be a 3-inch, 1/2-inch extension. And these are 1/2-inch drive sockets from 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and jumps right from 19 to 21. We have 1/2-inch, 9/16, 5/8, 11/16, 3/4, 13/16, and 7/8. Let's go over the side here, and looks like our Allen head bolts, or sockets for Allen bolts. You see these are quite common on older Chevys for their brake caliper bolts, holds them to the knuckle. So it's nice to see a set of these in here. Looks like they go from, let's get a better shot. Here we've got 5/32, 3/16, 1/4 inch, 5/16, and 3/8. Also looks like we have some screwdriver attachments for our sock or for our ratchets. Well, that looks, we've got a Phillips. We've got two Phillips. One's pointed, one's not as pointed. Have a square bit, and actually we have two square bits. That's kind of nice. So here we have our 3/8 ratchet. Push release for your sockets. 1/4 inch drive ratchet. And our 3/8 ratchet. Looks like a nut driver attachment for a socket, maybe? For a ratchet? That makes no sense. Just use a normal socket on there. But they go from 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, and looks like 12 millimeter. A little loose. Along with 9/32, 5/8, 11/32, 3/8, 7/16, and 1/2 inch. Just below that, we have, looks like Torx wrenches, Torx keys. I think they're Torx keys. Allen wrenches, ranging from 0.05, 1/16, 5/64, all the way up to 3/8. Don't know why that's not focusing. Up to 3/8. To the side of that, we have, looks like a 1 inch, well, maybe an inch and a half, 2 inch extension for the 1/4 inch ratchet. Same size or same length extension for the 3/8 ratchet. Just up from that, we have what looks to be all our screwdriver bits. Spin that around. So we've got some Phillips and looks like Torx bits. This one looks to be flathead, all the flathead sizes, and another Torx bit in there. These look like, let's see here. We have 2 Torx bits, 4 Phillips, and 3 squares. That's nice. So, lots of Phillips screwdriver attachments and lots of flatheads. Just lower down. Looks like Allen socket pieces or Allen bolt pieces for it for a screwdriver attachment. Just pull that out, make it loose. And then looks like we have some more Allen wrench pieces and another Torx bit. Lots of Torx bits in this thing. That's good. You're always stripping Torx bits. So down here, we have more Allen wrenches, ranging from 1.5 all the way. All the way up to a 10 mil. So those are some nice sizes in there. Gonna go to the side here and we've got all our Torx bits ranging from, we've got T15, 20, 25, 30, 40, 45, 50, and T55. So these are nice to have. Torx bits are very common on Jeeps and Dodge products. So those are nice to have, some of the more common sizes. And then just over here, looks like we have all of our shallow sockets. These are 1/4 inch drives from 5/32 up to 1/2 inch. And then more 1/4 inch drives. These are 12 points. So we've got some 12 point sockets in here. So this bottom row is 6 point sockets. This row here looks like all of them are 12 points. Going from 4, 4.5, 5, 5.5, 6, all the way up to 13. And then here are more 1/4 inch, ranging from 5/32 up to 1/2 inch, 12 point. And then looks like, oh nice, okay, so these two rows, this bottom and this second from the top, both of them are from 5/32 to 1/2 inch, 6 point, and 12 point. That's nice. And then both of these are four, basically from four, you know, with the odd half size, so 4.5 and 6.
So I'm just going to jump in here and say that I don't know what happened to the audio in the last few seconds of this clip here. It just kind of cut out and it jumped ahead of what I was actually recording on camera to what I was actually saying in audio. So I apologize if that confuses you guys.
And then both of these range from 4 up to 13 millimeter with your 12 points and your with your 12 points and your 6 points. With the variance of, you have a 4.5 millimeter here, and a 5.5 millimeter in here. So that's actually kind of a nice little thing in there. So here's this. Looks like a 1/4 inch driver. Screwdriver attachment, maybe? Oh, okay, there we go. So that looks like it's a 1/4 inch driver with 1/4 inch screwdriver attachment. So I guess you could use this with your 1/4 inch ratchet and your screwdriver bits if you wanted to. Just kind of sat nicely in here. I guess all you gotta do is really just stab it with your driver and just kind of cinches onto place. Which makes sense for what these would be for then. You could just put these right into there, and now you have an 11 millimeter nut driver now. Okay, well, that's nice. That's on there good too. So that's really nice. So I'll go pop that back in there. The screwdriver back in here. I guess we'll take a bit of a closer look at the ratchets now.
Alright, so now the fun part for me begins. I get to play with the ratchets. I'll start with my 1/4 inch. Let's put a socket on there. So, socket's just... Okay, so you actually gotta push the button, put the socket on. That holds it into place so it can't pop off. Not a really fine tooth count. I'd say that's about roughly a 40 tooth count, 40, 45 tooth. No, it's not horrible. No, it's not good though either. You know, it's kind of an in between of why bother buying it and good. It'll do the job. Now, like I said, this is to stick behind the back seat of a vehicle. I'm gonna put it in the back seat of my truck, so that if I break down on the side of the road, something happens on the road, I've got a small portable toolkit to use. You know, it doesn't have everything that I need, but it has a lot of items that I'm sure I can make do with, you know, changing a belt on the side of the road, swapping out a tail light because it burnt out, flat tire, use the half inch with the extension and a socket on it to break the lug nuts loose. So yeah, that's the quarter inch socket or the ratchet. Put that back and put the socket away. And the 3/8. Grab a socket for that one too. And have to push it on into place. So it's got a nice good feel to it, nice good grip on the handle. See the way that its shape contours into the hand nicely when you got, you know, really trying to torque on a bolt. Just spin this to go from loosening to tightening. It's definitely got a good grip to it. Good feel in the hand. I'm not gonna get cramps or anything using this, which is nice. Put that one back. Socket back. And I'll go grab the big half inch. I'll throw a socket on there too. Got a good feel in the hand too. Actually has a fair bit of weight to it. I'd say that's a good 2 pound. Yeah, weighs about 2 pounds. Nice decent weight for a Mastercraft. This isn't the Mastercraft Professional. You know, I've used Mastercraft Professional tools before. I like them. They're cheap. You know, you get what you pay for. But they do the job for me really well when working on vehicles in the yard. This one, you know, it feels cheaper, definitely feels cheaper than the professional brand of Mastercraft here. But all in all, this would do in a pinch on the side of the road, pulling over, help out somebody else on the side of the road, pull this out. You know, you've got a lot of your tools here for your Dodge, your Chevy, your Ford, with your Torx bits and your Allen bits and all that jazz, your inverted Torx bits. So you've got a decent variety of sockets to use on these. What I really would like to see in a toolkit like this would be a breaker bar. I can pull it the half inch and throw an extension on it and, you know, see if I've got a piece of pipe in the back of the truck to add onto this handle here. But honestly, I would much rather see an actual 2-foot breaker bar on this for a half inch sockets. That would just make this kit just a little bit better. Put that back. I would also like to see more than just 3 extensions. I would like to see 2-inch extension for the half inch, 3/8, and the quarter inch drive, but I would also like to see a 4-inch extension in all 3 sizes as well. It wouldn't take up that much more room in the toolkit. You know, it would add another 10 pounds to it. The thing weighs probably 40 pounds right now, but with a breaker bar and 6 extensions, you know, 3 more of these, just a little longer. I'd also like to see some form of hitting tool. You know, if they were just to, you know, give you a steel handle, you know, if they made something kind of like this, steel handle with just a small hammer head on top of this, it would save a lot of frustration too when working on your vehicle or on the side of the road, or just for your small backyard guys who tinker on their projects on weekends. You know, just it'd be nice to have it in there. There's a little bit of space in there that they could have in addition to that in there. So you can, you know, got a ball joint that's stuck or a tire rod that's stuck and you're trying to hit the knuckle. Well, you're not gonna use this, you're gonna go for your hammer. But if you're on the side of the road or on the trails, let's say you're an off-roader, You want something that's going to be good for you on the trail, something light, something that's not going to weigh you down heavily. Having a small hammer, something the size of this, to smack your steering knuckle, to drop the ball joint, to drop the tie rod end on, you know, that'd be great. Or changing a U-joint on a drive shaft or an axle shaft. Something like this to hit it with would be great. Unfortunately, that's not in the kit. All in all, my opinions, my views upon this toolkit. I'll just close up the box here. It does have 233 pieces. Can't complain about that too much. For the toolkit that it is, for the price that it is, or that it was on sale, I'd give it a 3 out of 5 stars for it. I haven't used it yet, but from the other types of tools that I've used, this just doesn't seem of the greatest type of starter kit or whatnot. But yeah, no, basically, it is a decent toolkit all in all. So, would I recommend it? Yes. Would I use it as a professional kit? You know, would I take it to the job, to the shop, and use it there to work on customers' vehicles? Probably not. It's just, it's not that up to par. You know, I wouldn't use it for, a roadside assistance call with the shop. I'd go and take my 400-piece mechanics toolkit, portable toolkit, which is I have right now, solely designed just for that. So, give it a lock up. This does work nice. It's heavy. It's got a solid handle on it, built into the case, so you don't have to worry about it breaking. It doesn't twist. And actually has rubber grip handles on it too. I'll provide just a little bit more comfort while carrying and holding this thing. So, if you like this video, please remember to comment, like, or subscribe, and stay tuned for more updates. Thank you.